we are then in one of the fastest growing cities in the United States, the fabulous Austin in the great state of Texas. The circuit itself, 14 miles southeast of the city center and home to the US Grand Prix since 2012. The latest in a long list of iconic tracks to have that honor. We have 10 turns to the left and 10 to the right here at the fantastic Circuit of the Americas, overtaking opportunities into turn 1 and 12 at this anti-clockwise 3.6 mile track. And we should see average lap speeds of around 126 miles per hour. And with me as usual is Anthony Davidson. Why don't we kick off by discussing Max Verstappen? Looks like they've got a tough race in store today, as grid penalties from changing power unit components has forced them further down the field.
But on the bright side, at least those fresh components can help them maintain the power they need to come through the pack. I expect to see them take a more aggressive approach today to make up for the compromised start.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Norris, Perez, Charles Leclerc and Sainz, Russell, Vettel, Stroll and Esteban Ocon, Raikkonen, Ricciardo, Antonio Giovinazzi, Moore, Mazepin, Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher. They've taken a grid penalty. And Nicholas Latifi, Verstappen and Pierre Gasly picks up the final grid slot today. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Okay, I know it's your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Don't take unnecessary risks. Caution, the virtual safety car has just been deployed due to a buildup of debris on the track. Drop your speed, our delta is too low. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending, wait for green.
Talk to me, Ants. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, they played the safety car to absolute perfection. There are so many factors to worry about once the race is neutralised. I mean, do you pit for fresh rubber? Do you have the space behind you? How much fuel can you save? If you answer all of those questions correctly, you'll have a good chance. And that's exactly what happened today.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. Let's take a look at the driver standings. This result narrows the gap between our championship leader and the rest of the standings. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Often my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Max Verstappen's solid, clean driving throughout the event.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action.